Dear students, now we will see problems in ad hoc network. Ad hoc network must propagate messages from one wireless station to the next until they reach the destination or a broader. There are two terms in the ad hoc network, that is single hop and multi hop. In the single hop, wireless station communicate directly with the base station, whereas in the multi hop, the wireless station can communicate with the base station through the various nodes. So these are the two concepts in ad hoc network. So the problems associated with this ad hoc network is, first is the routing. So there are several security risks associated with routing. The first is the spoofing, in which one node impersonate another. An example of this type of attack is ARP spoofing, in which one machine responds to an ARP, that is address resolution protocol request meant for another machine. Okay, or after doing so, traffic intended for the original machine is sent to that impersonator. And another attack is the ARP cache poisoning, causes all traffic to pass through this malicious node. This is a malicious node. And if sender wants to communicate anything with the receiver, then it passes through this malicious node. So that is the ARP poisoning. Next issue is the pre-keying issue. So as we have know the concept, that is encryption. So one problem when encryption or authentication is the key management, which involves creating, then sharing, storing and revoking encryption keys. So public key encryption is one way to avoid needing a key exchange. If a symmetric algorithm is used, then the two endpoints must agree on a key, either via key exchange protocol such as IKEA or Diffie-Hellman algorithm. For some application, because of entire either network or procedure limitations or application constraints, a high cost key exchange protocol is not practical. For example, if that application is very small, like predicting the temperature or humidity, so in that case predicting the weather, so it an ad hoc network of low powered sensor that report the weather data periodically, such as temperature and dew point. So it is intended to run only for a week or for the week only. So in that case, it is not possible or feasible to use the key exchange protocol. So that is the one issue. Next is the reconfiguring poses another problem in ad hoc networking, because ad hoc networks are by nature dynamic, as the node is moves from one place to the another. So the infrastructure is not fixed, it is dynamic, and nodes move as they go out of radio contact with some other nodes and come into contact with the other nodes. Okay, so here the network topology itself changes over time. This means that a previous node route from node X and to the node Y may change over time. It means that is not no longer work. So ad hoc routing algorithm must be able to reconfigure the underlying view of the network dynamically. So in addition, some segments of the network may become unreachable. Two nodes that were in contact previously now may lose contact, because as the nodes are moved from one place to the another, so it may be possible that they may break their contact. So that is the concept, that is reconfiguring. Next is the hostile environment. The mobile environment is often more hostile than the non-mobile one. In a non-mobile environment, the physical boundaries and barriers have more meaning and change. Means in the wired or non-mobile application, the physical boundaries of the application is fixed, as well as barriers have more meaning and change less frequently. In a mobile environment, eavesdropping is easier, so physical location offer are not secured. For example, coffee shops and airports and nodes go in and out of contact regularly. So that is the hostile environment. In that, we can say that in the mobile environment is often more hostile, means the infrastructure is not fixed here. So these are the issues in the ad hoc network. So thank you so much.